2017 LCN Talent Show. My name is Alec Deem, and this is Anna Hadfield, and we will be hosting the talent show for you tonight.
I am so happy that you could all make it out here tonight. I would like to inform you all that we're doing something a little bit different this year. Due to the amount of singing acts we had at auditions, we decided to split the show into two acts. First act will be singing, and the second will be non-singing.
This also means that we will be having two winners and two runner-ups picked separately from each act. Both will be announced at the end of the show.
A portion of the proceeds collected from entry will be donated to the charity Turning Point. Turning Point is targeted to help women and children out of domestic violence situations.
So without further ado, let's get started. First up, we have Kyle Bailey.
Kyle is a senior at LCN and has been playing guitar for 8 years and been singing for 12. He is self-taught and hopes to become an entertainer and let people enjoy his music. In his free time, he enjoys playing the guitar, drums, and piano. He also loves singing and being a bit of a comedian.
Now please welcome Kyle Bailey performing Shape of You by Ed Sheeran.
Club is the best place to find love, so the bar is where I go. Me and my friends at the table doing shots, drinking fast, and then we talk slow. Come over, start a conversation, readjust me, trust me, I'll give you a chance. And now to my hand, stop, tell the man the jukebox, and then we start to dance. And I'm singing like, girl, you know I want your love. Your love was handmade for somebody like me. Coming out for my lead, that made me crazy, don't mind me. Say, boy, let's not talk too much. Grab by my waist and put that body on me. Coming out for my lead, I'm coming out for my lead. Mm-hmm. I'm in love with the shape of you, push and pull like a magnet too. Though my heart is falling too, I'm in love with your body. And last night you were in my room, and I'm a bitch, you'd smell like you. Every day's covering something brand new. I'm in love with your body, oh why, oh why, oh why, oh why. I'm in love with your body, oh why, oh why, oh why, oh why.
Who has been performing ever since she was a little girl. In her free time, she enjoys singing, taking part in plays, and hanging out with her friends. Alyssa has been performing in talent shows ever since grade school and is taken back being that this is her last talent show. Next year, Alyssa will be attending Adrian University for Psychology and Interior Design.
Please welcome Alyssa Essery singing Say Something.
Thank you.
Junior at LCN, who has been singing since she was 4 years old. When she grows up, she would like to pursue a career in singing or acting. Paige also enjoys performing in plays and musicals at LCN. She is very excited to be performing in her first LCN talent show.
It is my pleasure to introduce Paige, who will be singing Rise Up by Andra Day.
Broken down and tired of living life on a merry-go-round, and you can't find a fighter, but I see it in you, so we gon' walk it out and move mountains, and we gon' walk it out and move mountains. And I
Awesome job, Paige. Next up, we have McKenna Mason and Shannon Boyle.
They are both juniors at LCN. McKenna has been taking vocal lessons for 3 years, and Shannon has been taking piano lessons for 8 years. McKenna hopes to open up a performing arts center for special needs children when she grows up, while Shannon hopes to raise a family when she grows up. They are both thrilled to be performing for you tonight.
Let us welcome to the stage McKenna Mason singing Skinny Love, accompanied by Shannon Boyle on the piano. She hopes to have a career on Broadway. Her hobbies include singing, color guard, robotics, and karate.
Without further ado, here's Claire Patterson singing Breathe from In the Heights. Woo! She is very excited to be performing in the talent show this year. Let's all welcome Juliana singing Hallelujah by Leonard Cohen.
Careful music, too.
freshman at LCN. Sam enjoys singing, listening to music, and playing with her dog. Armando enjoys singing, bowling, and video games. Sam hopes to be a teacher in the future, while Armando hopes to be a surgeon.
It's my pleasure to introduce Sam and Armando singing Like I'm Gonna Lose You by Meghan Trainor and John Legend.
Found myself dreaming in silver and gold, like a scene from a movie that every broken heart knows. We were walking on moonlight, you pulled me close. Split second, then you disappeared, and then I was all alone. Woke up in tears, you by my side.
Just to whisper a smoke, you could lose everything. The truth is you'll never know. So I kiss you longer, babe.
Yeah.
Every chance that I get, I'll make the most of the minutes in love.
Amazing job, guys. Last up before intermission, we have Bina Khan.
Bina is a junior at LCN. She's been singing ever since the eighth grade. She takes voice lessons as well. She enjoys singing, acting, and playing soccer. Fun fact about Bina, one time in kindergarten, she ran right into a flagpole and was knocked unconscious.
Without further ado, here is Bina Khan singing Burn from Hamilton.
when we saw your first letter arrive. She said, be careful with that one, love. You'll do what it takes to survive. You and your words flooded my senses. Your sentences left me defenseless. You built me palaces out of paragraphs. You built cathedrals. I'm rereading the letters you wrote me. I'm searching and scanning for answers and every line for some kind of sign when you were mine. The world seemed to burn. You published the letter she wrote you. You told the whole world how you brought this girl into our bed. In clearing your name, you have ruined our lives. Do you know what Angelica said when she read what you've done? She said, you have married an Icarus. He has flown too close to the sun. You and your words obsessed with your legacy. Your sentences bordered on senseless. And you are paranoid in every paragraph, how they perceive you. I'm erasing myself from the narrative. Let future historians wonder how Eliza reacted when you broke her heart. You have torn it all apart, I'm watching it burn. Watching it burn. The world has no right to my heart. The world has no place in our bed. They don't get to know what I said. I'm burning the memories, burning the letters that might have redeemed you. You forfeit all rights in my heart. You forfeit the place in our bed. You'll sleep in your office instead, with only the memories when you were mine. I hope that you
sessions in the lobby. All proceeds go to LCN's Camp Cavell. Run free. See you in 15 minutes.
Welcome back, everyone.
Who's ready for the second act?
All right. Okay. First up, we have Jacob Roberts, Dean Zelenak, Ryan Heath, Jacob Guy performing as a band. Mostly self-taught, these guys love producing music together. After only being together for a few months, they are very proud of the music they've been able to produce. Outside of school, you can find them practicing all their respective instruments on a regular basis. Jacob Guy plays the drums, Brian Heath is on bass, Dean Zelenak is on guitar, and Jacob Roberts is on vocals.
Without further ado, welcome FMB performing Sugar We're Going Down by Fall Out Boy.
We'll be right back.
He is a self-taught magician and has been performing for just over 3 years. When he is older, he hopes to graduate from a 4-year university as a political science major. His other hobbies outside of school include fishing, boating, and just being involved in school in general.
Let's all give a warm welcome to Jack Magic.
Yeah, Jack!
Hello everybody, I'm Jack Magic. I hope everyone's had a good evening so far, and I'm gonna spice things up here. For those of you who know me, I'm a close-up magician. I do a lot of card tricks, coin tricks, and making your money disappear, but that's not what I'm gonna be doing tonight. Tonight what I have is something a bit more dangerous. What I have here are 5 paper bags. Each of them inside is a wooden block just to weight them down, but inside of one of these paper bags here is a spike. This spike is very sharp, so sharp it could I'm not blowing it up that big, I don't have the lungs to do that. It could, yeah, it's tiny, so yeah, not as much of an effect. But that's not what happened. See, what we're going to do is we're gonna place this in there. I'm going to mix up the bags. Now I'm gonna have members of our audience here pick which ones I will slam my hand down. Hopefully it's the right one and that spike does not go through my hand. This is a very serious trick. I do not suggest doing it at home. When I saw it on TV and they said, do not attempt this at home, I thought, I'm gonna do that. Don't do that. So what we'll do is I'm gonna take all the spikes here. Remember, the spikes in this bag, it's not gonna be like right here forever, but just remember. So here's what we're gonna do. I'll take it, I'm gonna fold each of the bags here over, and I'm just gonna take them, I'm gonna mix them up behind my back, I'll grab these two here. And what you members of the audience here have to do is keep track of which one's where it was, where the nail will be in here now. Is everybody still watching? Because you need to know. My hand's at risk here. I'm a magician, I use them a lot. So what I'm going to do is we're gonna mix them up a few more times just like that. Are they good or should I mix them up more?
More!
More! Mixed up. I need some people just to stand. I'm gonna call on you. When I call on you, I want you to stand up and you are going to pick which one of these bags I will slam my hand down, possibly putting a nail through it and putting me in severe pain, needing an EMT to take me out and bandage up my hand. But let's hope that doesn't happen. Okay. We'll go right over here in the pink glasses. Yep. Can now here's what I have. I have the five bags here. We're gonna number them. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 in a very loud, clear voice. Can you say which one you want me to slam my hand down onto?
3.
3, are you sure? That was really quick.
Yes.
Like no thought, are you sure?
5, 5, 5, 5.
I heard 3. Okay, ready? 1, 2, 3. There goes not one. There goes one, okay. Now see, here's the thing, now we are down to a 25% chance of my hand having a spike through it. Let's hope that doesn't happen again. Now we have 4 bags. It was 20% because 100 over 5 is 20, yeah, math. So here's what we're gonna do. We have 4 bags left. I need one person to just be really loud. Standing up with both arms in the air. Yeah, you're pointing to yourself now. Watch, we've got 1, 2, 3, and 4. Can you very loudly shout 1, 2, 3, or 4? Whoever said 5, there's only 4. Is 4 good? I'm hearing 4. Okay. Is 4 good? Okay, ready? Number 4. My hand. Spike in one of these. Let's see. 1, 2. Okay, we're safe again. Good. Oh, thank God. Didn't make it this far in rehearsal. Okay, so we have 3 bags left. We have a 33.3% chance. You hear a lot of noise over here, so we're gonna go over here. Okay, I see somebody up in the back waving your arms right now. Awesome, you're still waving your arms. What I want you to do is we have 3 bags here. I want you to just shout out number 1, number 2, or number 3. Could you say that?
Number one.
Are we sure?
Yes.
Okay, my hand's at risk here. I don't. Okay, ready? Number 1. Okay. 1, 2, 3. Oh my God, that was close. All right. We are down to 2 bags. One of these has a spike in it, one of them does not. Meaning, there is a 50-50 shot of me having a spike in my hand. Again, not good. Okay, we need one more. Here, actually, I need somebody who would want to do like something crazy. I need somebody who would do something crazy. Can you come up on stage? Okay, come on up here. What's your name?
Nate.
Let's give a big round of applause for Nate really quick. Now, Nate, here we have bag number 1 and bag number 2. Can you hold 2 hands over each? Now it's your turn. I'm joking. No, what I want you to do is kind of just get a feel of which bag is safe, which one isn't. You're not liking that one. Are you sure? So this one's safe?
Yeah.
I'm joking. No. I would never do that. No, but I would do that to me. Are you sure this one's safe? I almost slammed your hand down on it, so I've got to take like your trust that it's safe, right?
It's 100% safe.
100%. Okay, ready? This is the final. We have 2 bags. This is the final bag I will slam my hand down on. Do you think this one is safe? You can still change your mind. You got pinky promise, awesome. Ready? 1, 2. Oh my God! No, I'm kidding, we're good. Okay, and that means in the last bag here, in here, down in the bottom, is the wooden block with the nail in it. There it is, and if that was me, that could have been my hand with a spike through it. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, Major Conductor, for seeing. But see, when I started out today, I said I did a lot of close-up magic, and I would like to do something for our judges sitting in the back there. So what I have here is a deck of cards. It's basically what I grew up on, playing cards. So here's what we're going to do. I'm going to go down to our fabulous judges here. And here's what we're going to do. We have our row of judges here. I'm going to go to Mr. Lady because you're right here. Here's what I'm going to do. We've got a pack of playing cards here. Can you confirm all of them are different?
Yes, all different.
All of them are different? Awesome. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm just going to go through the deck like that. I want you to call out stop whenever you would like, okay? Right there, you're short. Okay, watch. Take that card. Take a look at it. Don't show it to me. Hold on to it. Don't show anybody else in the audience. Here's what's going to happen. This will be great. For the first time, now that I'm back on stage, I have the deck of cards. There's no way I can know what your card was. Can you say in a very loud voice, what's the card you have?
Ace of Diamonds.
The Ace of Diamonds. Is that right? Can you show it to everybody? Now see, here's what's so neat is that I made sure that, like, it's so crazy that you picked the ace, because see, on my shirt here, I have the Ace of Diamonds. But see, here's what's even cooler. Everybody in the audience, look at your programs, look at my name. If you look at the name of my act, it actually says on there, the Ace of Diamonds. Look right off to the left. It will say the Ace of Diamonds on it. All right, everybody, that's my pick for tonight. Thank you for being an amazing audience. And thank God there's not a spike in my hand.
Amazing job. Next up, we have Zero.
Zero is a senior at LCN. He has never performed before, so he's absolutely thrilled to be in the talent show this year. His hobbies include playing the piano and playing sports. He has had training for the piano for many years.
Please welcome to the stage Zero playing the Turkish March by Mozart on the piano. Thank you. Lynn is a sophomore at LCN. She has been playing the piano for almost 8 years. She dreams to be independent, have a bunch of dogs, and be happy and proud of herself. Her hobbies include volunteering at the Detroit Medical Center and taking dogs on walks. She's very excited to perform for all of you.
Please welcome to the stage Lynn Lamb performing Dancing on the Berlin Wall on piano. Next up, we have Savannah Johnson. Savannah is a junior at LCN. She's been acting for 5 years. She takes the acting classes over at the Pankhouse Center during her school day. She dreams to be either an actress or sound designer on Broadway. When not acting, Savannah enjoys reading, hiking, yoga, and work.
Without further ado, here is Savannah performing the monologue Loved, which she wrote herself.
Look, I don't need to be here, okay? I'm fine. But if this is gonna make my mom feel better about the whole thing, then whatever. Why am I here? Well, I thought you'd know that already. What? Didn't take the time to read your little file that tells you everything you wanna know about me? Fine, you can hear it from me, whatever. I'm best friends with a girl. I love her. Everyone loves her. She's smart, Funny, kind, she gets good grades, does well at sports, has a lot of friends, the whole package. And then she kills herself. My mom thinks it's going to make me depressed, so bada bing, bada boom, I end up with a shrink. What? Thought I'd be more upset? Well, I'm sorry, I just met Hugh, I don't know Hugh, and I certainly don't feel like pouring my heart out to you. No, I... Well, yeah. No, it's your job, I get it. I'm sorry, I don't know what came over me, I just, ever since... You know, she could do that too. Make me open up and talk about all of these things I barely knew I was feeling myself. She did it whenever I was upset or just couldn't find the right words. You know, I hope she was happy. Is that wrong? I mean, it shouldn't be wrong to hope your best friend is happy before she dies, but God, it sounds so wrong. To say I hope she didn't regret her suicide? How do you make that sound normal? It doesn't. It sounds horrible, but it's true. I guess if she couldn't be happy here, then I just hope she was happy leaving. I don't know. And I mean, it's not like I'm saying this because I don't miss her. Of course I do. Whenever I hear a joke I know she would have laughed at, or that stupid car commercial jingle, oh my God, it was always stuck in her head. She would hum it when she was taking a test or doing her nails or just plain bored all the time. It was so annoying. But the worst is always when I'm in a crowded room and I hear a voice or a laugh that sounds just like hers, or I see a flash of a face that has her eyes and her hair, and I whip around so fast it hurts, and I'm just painstakingly searching to see her again so I can hold her and tell myself it was just a dream. It was a dream. She's still here. Of course she is. She's not going anywhere. She said she wouldn't, and she won't. And I mean, how do you stop? How do you stop hoping to see your best friend again? How do I stop hoping I get to tell her I love her and go to sleepovers and laugh and gossip and study? How do I stop missing her? I can't. And I mean, I told her I would never give up on her. I told her that, and I won't. I swear to God, I won't. I love her. I loved her. Loved.
Great job, Savannah. Next, we have Deja Jones.
Deja is a freshman at LCN. She has been dancing and performing since the fifth grade. When she grows up, she hopes to be a professional dancer and choreographer. Her hobbies include dancing and playing volleyball. She takes dance classes at the Pankhouse Center and is so excited to be performing for you tonight.
Here is Deja dancing to Beyoncé's I Woke Up Like This remix.
Ladies, I'm a
We have Julie Belloli.
Julie is a junior at LCN. She's been dancing for 13 years. She hopes to be a teacher when she grows up, and her hobbies include competitive dancing and marching band. She is so excited to be performing at the talent show this year.
Please welcome to the stage Julie Belloli performing to Love It Back.
Remember when you were 4 and you didn't even know what your body was supposed to look like, what it was supposed to be, what it meant to be skinny or fat or short? Remember when you didn't even know what perfect meant? When did someone tell you what imperfect was? How did they define it? What flaws were? When did you first notice something wrong with your body, with your skin, with yourself? Why did you think this? We hate on our bodies that we own, that we carry, that we are in for our entire lives. We try to change the body our sister looked up to, not for what our skin covered, but for the way we carry ourselves. When did you start caring about a scale and stop caring about yourself? When did curves become negative? When did bones out of hips and spaces between thighs become beautiful? When did we start striving for what we saw in others? When did comparing yourself become more powerful than the comfort of your home? Your body is your home. When did you start treating your home like it was messy? Like you needed to clean until it was spotless, until there was nothing left inside? When did you lose control of your self-love to gain control of your self-hate? To look at your body and not want to get rid of every stupid flaw, disfigurement, bump, fat, extra, yelling at you, you're ugly, that you're not worth the heart that's in you, that if you look like what you want to, like her, like him, you will be happy, and you will love yourself, and you look perfect. No, that demon that has grown so aggressive is wrong. That demon who has taken over the acceptance of yourself will never give anything back to you, will never be satisfied, will never be happy. He will take and take and take. You have no idea how beautiful you are. Those thighs that squish together and brush each other every time you walk, it's beautiful. The butt you have that sticks out plump and bubbly, it's beautiful. Those stretch marks that look like rivers and constellations telling where your skin has swam and been, they're beautiful. Those scars, those marks, those blemishes that show you're human, they're beautiful. Your worth is not defined by numbers. Your worth is not defined by what you see in the mirror. Your worth is not your body. Love your body like you love another. Your body loves you so much. Love it back.
Beautiful job, Julie. Last up, we have EXO.
He is a senior at LCA. He has been dancing for just over a year now. He hopes to be recognized for his dancing talents. His hobbies outside of dance include rollerblading and hanging out with his friends. Being this is his first time performing, he is so excited to be in the show.
Please welcome to the stage, EXO performing a hip-hop dance. At this time,
time, our judges are tallying their scores. We would like to give a few shout-outs in the meantime.
We would first and foremost like to thank Mr. O for advising and overseeing the talent show, along with Faith Barraway, Jane Ann Paratori, Olivia Swad, Tony Green, and Chloe Marquette.
Another huge shout-out to Mr. Kroll, Mr. Allwert, Ms. Merkel, Mr. Lady, and Ms. McCumber for judging tonight's show. And also a big shout out to Mr. Willenberg for accompanying a few of our acts on the piano.
Another thank you goes out to JPAC and their crew for allowing us to use the auditorium.
Don't forget to come out on December 18th and support LCN choirs as they put on their Christmas concert. Another reminder is that Bye Bye Birdie auditions, this year's musical, will take place next week, Monday through Thursday, after school in the LGI. Audition packets are available in the choir room or outside Mr. Allwood's room.
While we wait, we have some jokes for you.
Yeah. Who's ready?
I don't think you're ready.
They're really good.
Yeah. Okay. All right, where does a piano player go on vacation? Anyone know? I heard it. Say it louder. Thank you, thank you. Nice job.
You get a point.
Yeah.
All right, next. What key, it's a key thing, has legs and can open doors?
What?
Who said it?
Who said it?
Yes!
Alright, we have a third one. What kind of music are balloons afraid of? Say it louder!
Okay, 3 points. Let's see if we get the last one. Ready? Okay. What is Beethoven doing right now? No,
not quite. Almost.
Decomposing,
you got it.
Very nice.
Yes. How did you guys like the show? Shout out your favorite contestant. Go, shout it out. Shout out. For the judges' scores.
Alex.
Oh no. Do you want to sing a duet?
Yeah. Okay.
This is on the star. Yeah.
Twinkle,
twinkle, little star. How I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high. Like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star. How I wonder what you are. Contestants out on stage. Let's give a round of applause again. For the person who's going to be going home with $25. Yeah. All right, our first runner-up for the singing portion of the LCN Talent Show 2017 is, drum roll, Bina Khan.
Drum roll. This person will win
$50. $50. All right, ready? Sam Keswick and Armando Crespo.
$50 win. All right, drum roll, please. The winner of first place is...